No, but this is a night routine. Ivy, say hi, girl.
Hi.
We gotta run to the store, you guys. Because babe's making dinner, but we ran out of heavy whipping cream for chicken Alfredo. So me and Ivy are gonna run to the store real quick. And then we're gonna start the nighttime routine. So stay tuned. Jesse, look, it's you. Jesse. Jesse.
Welcome to the church, volume 2. Exclusive 213. Got my nephew, Nate. Hey, y'all, hi, Adam. Where you at?
No.
Say hi.
Hi. JJ, no, please don't do that to Sissy. Here, can we share? Let's share. No.
Okay. She's not gonna share. Here, Jesse, don't play with mommy's shoes. Dinosaur. No. Knock it off. No. This is Ivy being an angel. Her hair is a mess. Baby's right here chilling, watching him some Octonauts. The floor is a mess. And I already shredded up the chicken for babe.
Mommy,
hey, babe.
What are you doing?
I'm making a night routine.
Mommy, stop it.
This is the noodles. This is for the sauce. And this is the shredded up chicken. How come you're eating it? Oh, she's eating it.
Mmm, that's good.
Thanks, I made it. I'm just kidding, babe. So yeah, guys, that's all that's going on right now. We're just making dinner, and then once I make the kids' plates, then I will come back and show you guys, because I'm not making dinner. Babe is making dinner, so I will come back and show you guys. Say, we will come back and show you guys when we're eating.
You don't like that? You don't like it.
All right, guys. Over and out. Ava, say over and out. Well, Ivy's in trouble. Daddy said he already told you no about going outside right now because dinner's done. Okay?
I'll just go out tomorrow.
So, all the kids are eating. Babe is eating. And I made my mom some food because she's going to be coming over after she leaves the library, and I'm gonna make my plates when everybody else is satisfied, because that's how being a wife and a mom is. Satisfy everyone else and then yourself, but don't forget to self-care. Is it good?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Daddy. I'm gonna buy mommy.
What a mommy?
Okay. Yeah. Can I too?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You need to try the shrimp.
Okay.
Face me. Face me.
Mmm.
Pretend it's your child.
It's good. Go put it on your plate. Scoot her regular Alfredo over, or not.
On a scale from 1 to 10, I rate it 10 out of 9.
Babe, what do you rate it? It's your food, so you gotta give it a high rating.
He's been had this.
You would say a half out of 10.
Huh?
Some half out of 10.
7.5? Why?
Bruce has got more chicken in
there. Harvey wants to try the baby's milk.
One time.
Yeah, go. Jesse, stop. Is it good? We were eating dinner on the floor. Whew, I got a little food, baby, up in there. But we have a dining room table, but we like to watch TV while we're eating. So that's why we were on the floor. But it's 6:15 right now. The kids' bedtime is 7. And this is typically the time when I let them play for a little bit longer, and then we'll start picking up the living room so that we can go ahead and start getting ready for bed. Like a burp.
Yeah, everybody.
Oh, this is also part of our night routine. Babe thinks he has to get on the game every single night right before I put the kids to bed. So, yeah. I love you, babe. You didn't hear me. All right, guys. It's 6:55. We're going to start making the toddlers their cups. This is JJ's and this is Ava's. Ava drinks through a straw. JJ can, but he makes a mess. I'm confused. Anyways. They're in the bottom. So the bottom, down at the bottom. JJ likes juice, so I'm gonna give him this. And Ava won't drink anything other than chocolate milk. It's okay, we have a box of them over there. Box of size 6, so. Ava, go to the potty, please. Here. Go to the potty. Go get on the potty. Here's JJ's. The house is a mess. I'll go help JJ because he's still. You said what? Get milk. Hi. See? He's coming to get me so he can get in the bed. But we do that. That's why we put the ceiling fan in here, because we want this room to be the coolest. We have an air conditioner in our room, and we have an air conditioner down in the living room, so that pretty much keeps the downstairs cool. But upstairs, we need to get a more powerful one, because upstairs is just super hot, and it's like unrealistic for them to continue to keep sleeping up here, like in the fall and spring. Like, the only time we have a hard time is in the summer. The summer is terrible, but other than that, and he has to sleep with shorts on, because last night he's sleeping with girl covers on his bed, because last night he decided right after bath time to take his diaper off, because I only left a diaper on him. I didn't put any clothes on him because of the heat. He took it off. Did you poop, baby? Mm-hmm. I don't completely enjoy it. Like, see, I've done some stuff. Like, don't mind this toolbox right here, because my husband was doing something in here earlier. But I put their animal thing up. I filled their little nightstands with their clothes. And the cribs are, like, assembled. But, like, as far as curtains, and I haven't even vacuumed in here. So, don't get me wrong. There's a lot that needs to be done. But I've also done some stuff. So, don't think I've just done nothing. I have been doing things when I am in here. I think I'm just going to take this out because it's pretty hot. I'll leave the sheet in there. And every night, JJ sleeps with his Cody from Cocomelon, and then he has a giraffe that he sleeps with too. Yes?
Here's that for you, baby. I love you.
Hello.
No. I love you. And JJ watched Octonauts every night. He watches Octonauts. That's his favorite little cartoon. He used to like Boss Baby a lot more, but he switched up on Boss Baby. He switched up real quick. And this is the ceiling fan, you guys. I was telling you guys. But good night, baby.
Night night.
Night. He's so sweet.
Okay.
All right, he's done. Here's the girls. Night night, girls. Ava, did you get your diaper on? Let's go get diaper. Will mommy bring you diaper? Yes. I'll be right back. Huh? Say good night. They know you're Ava. Ivy, say good night. I love you guys. Don't be playing around, okay? Okay. All the kids besides the baby are in bed. So, what I'm thinking I'm gonna do... Hold on, let me sit you guys right here. Sit down for 1 second. That is all clean clothes. I have 2 baskets of clean clothes over here. So what I think I'm gonna do, all right, you guys, so I just made my bed. We're gonna start, I'm sorry, people keep texting me. We're gonna start sorting out the clothes into the different piles. I'm just dumping them all up here and we're gonna do it that way. A good thing about doing it this way, I'll say this. So a good thing about doing it this way is, one, if it's towels, I'm gonna fold them right now. And two, because I'm dumping them on my bed, I have no choice but to do all the sorting right now if I wanna go to sleep tonight. Me and Babe's clothes, so we, like you saw, we got all these baskets here, so I'm just gonna sort them to the different rooms they're going in. The girls, their stuff goes in one basket, Babe's stuff goes in his separate basket, and my stuff goes in my separate basket because we have separate closets, so. I'm just gonna start sorting through, but the my little desk area where I can edit and all that. That's Babe's closet. Okay, so here goes this bassinet we have to clear out. This is the girl's basket of clothes. I'm gonna sit right here because I'm gonna drop this off in their room because ain't neither of them asleep because Ava just decided to poop herself. And this is what I was telling y'all about. She poop herself every single night. After I put that diaper on her, she poop herself. That's why potty training is stressful. Believe the parents when they say it. So the bed's all cleared off. We got a pile of towels right here. I'm gonna go ahead, put downstairs. And yeah, I'm gonna take y'all downstairs with me. I'm gonna change Ava real quick. And then we're gonna start cleaning up downstairs. But yep, the room is clean.
Are you not hungry?
It's a mess in here. I'm trying to clean up as best I can.
I think I went in there.
Where?
In the bedroom.
Why? Taking off the bathroom?
Mm-hmm.
He had shorts on. You took your shorts off?
Oh, he took his shorts off.
Guys, the living room is always the messiest room in the house. Guys, I'm not even gonna lie to you. This is me being super realistic and raw. Like I told you guys earlier, I like my cleaning better, so I prefer to do the cleaning anyways. But it is a little frustrating that I do it every night repetitively and we don't just learn to pick up after ourselves as we go on throughout the day. I get we have younger children, so they can't necessarily, but like myself included, we need to learn how to just not leave cups on the floor. Don't leave your bowl on the couch. Don't bring covers downstairs you're not going to take back up. Like, just stuff like that. It's the little tedious things that kind of piss me off a little.
Frustrated, but
so this is as far as the living room is gonna get for tonight.
I think my fireplace is a mess. That's my husband's fault, but it's something I'm not willing to keep arguing with him about because I've said something about it too many times.
I was gonna make fried Oreos tonight because that's a really good late night snack, but I don't know if I have the appetite. The kitchen, it might seem like a huge mess to some people, but it's actually pretty good tonight. It's not that bad. At an angle where you guys can't really see me picking up all the trash, but husband has told me about giving the kids sweets on their plate before dinner, and I still continue to keep doing it, which I can't stand that I do that, but it's a habit I don't recommend. So I have these plates for the toddlers. With three different compartments, and I don't like them anymore because I feel obligated to use all three spaces. And my husband tells me all the time, don't give them something sweet before I give them like with their dinner, because then they just eat the sweet stuff. And today they had chicken Alfredo, a honey bun, and crackers. They ate the honey bun and the crackers, but they didn't eat their Alfredo. So I think I'm gonna stop using those plates. But the only thing is, the other plates they have two compartments, so even then it's not, I'm still trying to, you know, run around to figure out what I'm gonna make them, when I can literally just like, you know what, I'll just give you what's for dinner and that's that. And Ava has gotten so used to it that if I leave one of the spots blank, she'll literally be like, I dropped my fruit snacks, or I dropped my cookie. When she says I dropped, that means she wants it. So that's another thing. It's like they become accustomed to the fact that I give them three separate things, and they can just waste what they want to waste out of the food that is given to them. You guys, we got this pre-workout from Kroger. I think, if not yesterday, the day before. And I actually think I really like it. I've never had pre-workout before, and my husband, I think he said he hasn't either. And I actually like it. I see what the hype is about. Now, I wouldn't buy an expensive one because I don't see what's the point. If the Kroger brand works, why would I buy an expensive one? The wick ain't hit, you getting Kool-Aid in this house. Yeah, guys, this is like, I don't know if I included too much or too little. Like, not be choking on Kool-Aid. I don't know if I included too much or not enough in this night routine. I'll probably edit just a little bit of stuff out, like parts where I talk too much. But I think I did pretty good. Baby's crying. I tried feeding him. He didn't want that. His diaper's changed. He might be sleepy, but if he's sleepy, then I can help. I'm gonna add some water to this juice. I pretty much got it cleaned up in here. The dishes just have to be done now. And the dishes have to be done. And the food has to get put away. But that's only if it's not gonna get eaten tonight. Hey babe. How's it going? Was there bugs in it?
No. Standing in front of me.
Oh, okay.
And then I'll take it out there and I'll just do that.
I'm making juice so they can't drink just chocolate milk tomorrow, because JJ and Ava had huge explosions. Oh. And I'm not dealing with that again tomorrow. Ava pooped twice, actually.
Yes, she did.
Yeah, because she pooped right before I put her down and she just pooped again. And big diarrhea. Jade had the same exact poop as her. Same color and everything.
Love
you too. Alright. pink lemonade made. I'm gonna put that in the fridge. See, that's the dishes, which I don't think I'm doing right now. This Kool-Aid over here making noise. Can y'all hear that? Y'all probably can't because the baby crying. I'm gonna have to get him. It doesn't look like we're getting anything else done right now. And you guys, it's 8:17 right now. I'm looking at the stove. It's 8:17, which means since we put the kids to bed an hour ago, we already cleaned the living room, straightened up the kitchen. I'm not saying clean the kitchen because it's straightened up, but the dishes still need to be done and it still needs to be swept in here. So we we separated all the laundry, cleaned my room, and cleaned the living room. The only thing that has to be done now, the dining room has like three things on the floor that need to be picked up. Diaper bag needs to be put away, and then everything downstairs needs to be vacuumed. Other than that, we got a good amount of stuff done. So we gotta take a break to see what's wrong with the baby. Oh, he's very upset. I'm doing the wrong part and shit. I'm sorry, y'all. Alright, you guys, the bottle worked. He's good. He's content. He's eating. So since the bottle worked, we're gonna be right here in the dining room and we're gonna clean up. We still haven't figured out what we're gonna do with that big blue thing right there because it is in the way, but we don't know what to do with it because we don't want to sit outside and get bugs in it. We don't want to go in the basement and get spiders in it because that's where the kids go in every day when we bike ride. And it's not like we don't bike ride every day, so that's the only reason why we keep it right there. If we weren't going to use it every day, we would find somewhere for it to go, but we do use it every day. So no sense in us stressing ourselves out about it. And you guys, all this stuff, sister's nail stuff that she let me use, and other than vacuuming, which is probably not gonna happen because the baby keeps flipping out. And you guys, sometimes, I know some people might ask, I do hold him and feed him, but I like doing it this way because it's more independent. We do have four kids, so this is a lot easier for us, especially like if we want to cook dinner, like if there's only one of us here or something, which that's not often that there's only one of us, but my husband is going to be starting night shifts at work, so this will help me. Like when I'm putting the kids down for bed, he's sitting here eating his bottle. He doesn't typically cry, but my mom has been over the past few days and she has been babying him a lot, so he keeps thinking that he needs to be held all day. And I was telling her that's the problem with her constantly wanting to pick him up. We don't have time to constantly pick him up, so with her doing that, she's making it harder for us. I've explained that, but grandparents don't seem to want to listen ever. And the thing is, see, like, he's content right now, but he's also just not comfortable, I don't think. And once I start closing these blinds up and stuff, as you guys can see, I've got it like mostly picked up in here, as picked up as it's gonna get for the night. This is just about how good it's gonna get, besides me doing the dishes, which later on when I do the dishes, I'll probably show you guys that. But this is it, guys. The kids are down in bed. My husband is actually outside right now. Hold on, what happened? Okay, let's see. Let's What did we do wrong? What am I doing? Okay, I see what I did. Sorry, guys. My husband's outside right now putting together the weight bench. We have had a weight bench for a while, and it was actually inside of our basement. But again, the bug problem with the basement, so we don't want to work out down there. So he's outside right now putting it together. I don't want to show too much, but as you guys can see, he's out there doing his thing. Because in the mornings, typically, we be wanting to work out. And a few days, we went outside and we worked out. But he wanted to jump rope. That was his main thing. And, like, when he set on one thing, he set on one thing. And the kids, when they all came over, the cousins, they lost his, they lost our jump rope. So, now he can't jump rope anymore until we get a new jump rope. So, I think he's like, you know what? Weight bench. Because we've been trying to lose weight. So, now we're going to be able to use the weight bench.
Hey, babe. Before, you're sweating really bad. Huh? Is that bringing weights up on the
table? Don't think I'm hoping that the kids don't play. Yeah, I hope you bet. Your favorite parent. You must have gave him something to make him act this way towards me lately. Fuck that Conjuring movie and everything we're supposed to watch.